right, guys, welcome to today's Bureau Mail. It's 13:34 hours, and we got a little tiny bag. It's from Candy Cares. It's from Charles Selfridge. You know what to do with them. From GCSA. It's googly eyes.
Yeah, I put them with the other googly eyes so that they don't appear everywhere.
No, I made a specific comment that I can't mention here.
Oh, okay. I think I have to do fun things with googly eyes. We have a box from ISCA.
I get the most dainty, delicate packages in the mail.
You do. So very girly, really, the packages that you get. So I just learned what ISCA means, like 2 days ago.
Yeah, it's cool, isn't it?
They've been a sponsor forever. I just learned what ISCA means. Israeli Carbide.
Oh.
Yeah. I knew they were based out of Israel, didn't it? Paperwork. See, item description. These are the item descriptions. I'll just read two of them. Because usually you get this, and it's like 12 pack of widgets. Item description. Line 1. Item number 5622046. The item description. It is an ECRI-B3. 312-500/1.12C312. Now, there are people on Earth for whom that is an item description.
I've been waiting for that exact item.
Shut up. But unless you're ISCAR Rick or a freak, that's not an item description. That's a line of code.
It tells you the diameter, the radius of the tip.
Oh, I know. It tells you everything there is to know about it, but... Saying that's an item description, that's an item description only to a very tiny niche of people who understand it. Like if I say, yeah, I got a 94MX3. To most people that means nothing. Unless you know that the MX3 is a model of Mazda automobile that was made in 1994. It's just, I got a 94MX3. That's great. There's cream for that now. You can get that removed. So we have... It doesn't even put names on the thing! I'm just going to open a box to show people because... I'm not a wow. Oh, those are sexy. Look at that. Here, I'll put it down here on the mat so that you guys can see it, but it's actually really quite impressive. I have no idea what this is. I'm guessing it's an insert. Because if that's the whole bit,
it's
we got problems.
It's our chamfer.
Hey! That looks like it might go in there. And given the regularity with which they are eating up the cheap brand X tools in that particular application, that's a pretty cool place to have it. Cool. So those go together. And then we've got end mills. Ooh, a triple flute. That's sexy. Now, is that one of the anti-vibration ones where it's a little offset? Because they make a version of these where the three don't like... This is actually really cool. They make a tool like this with the three flutes where one of the flutes is a little bit off from the other two, so they're not like evenly spaced at 120 degrees apart, and it cuts down on the vibration, which is a pretty clever approach to it.
I know that I told Rick the material we were cutting and the diameters we needed.
Okay. And we have... It's sealed for your protection. So sexy when they're brand new. Look at that. Tool holders with a collet. Looks like an ER32 collet. So cool. Well, that's an ER32 collet holder. So we got a bunch of really sexy good stuff. Yeah, there's another one and another one.
They should be the same.
Yeah. They're pretty badass. So that is major new awesome love for the CNC shop. Shipped from ISCAR, which is Israeli Carbide.
These came from Arlington.
Huh?
These came from Arlington.
They probably started out in Israel. That's my guess. I don't know. Does this car have a factory like in America?
They have like 15 of them in different countries.
Okay.
For efficiency.
Okay.
There's a huge place in Arlington, Texas.
Yeah, I know they do big events down there.
Well, they make tools.
Okay, cool. Well, that's viewer mail for the day. We have googly eyes.
Okay.
And cutting tools for this car. So you're going to get to see these in application, building the new steam engine kits that'll be coming out really soon. You guys have fun. That's viewer mail for the day. We'll be back tomorrow with more. Guys, welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 12:36 hours on October 1st, 2014. There wasn't much for blog yesterday. We spent all day cleaning, so we're making up for it today. But Jerry's got news. What do you got?
I'm finally shipping tiles.
Okay, so you're shipping tiles in a big way.
Oh yeah. We've got it down to a nice little system. Let's grab one of these nice boxes. I think they're meant for books or whatnot, but they work really well for tiles. Since
okay.
You have to wrap them in bubble wrap. You just go in position it right. Go do that. Pull it in the sides. It's a lot easier when you have a camera pointed at you.
And there you go. You're shipping tiles. And they look like that when they're ready to go. That's excellent, sir.
That was one of the giant boxes in today's mail shipment.
Okay. And you're working on the new brochures?
Yes, the alignment is off.
Yes, okay. Keep right. And Ramon's back!
Hello.
Are you working on a model? Are you working on a model? Are you back? You're back working on a model?
I will be back.
We need the model. You will be back.
I
you're standing here right
on,
now.
On
you're
Monday.
Back. But it's but you're here.
When do you need the model?
Now?
Specifically which now, model?
The... Shit. I got so caught up in worrying about the model, I forgot which one I needed. The last one you were working on, the important one.
The windows?
Yeah, the windows. The windows for the ballet.
Yes.
Yes.
I will have that to you as soon as possible.
For reals?
For reals.
Okay. But you're not back today.
I'm not back today.
But you're standing here.
Yes.
Am I high?
No.
I'm high.
Nope.
Okay.
Well, maybe. I can't.
I don't think so. That. I don't feel high. Figment. If you're a figment of are you a pooka? Ramon's a puka. You don't know what a puka
American
is, do you?
Something? I don't know.
You don't know what a puka is?
I don't think so.
You never saw Harvey? You've never seen Harvey?
Oh my god.
Okay, between now and Monday, you have to see the movie Harvey.
Okay.
It's an old Jimmy Stewart movie. Okay.
Right.
Watch this. Watch it with your wife. It's a really sweet movie. It's really cool. Harvey. H-A-R-V-E-Y. Okay. Who is, by the way, the major donor of the day. He donated, like, almost $540 today. $560? Something like that. $560 today, donated by Harvey.
Gonna get you that fire truck?
Huh?
Gonna get you that fire
truck? We're, like, 66% of the way to the fire truck.
That's good.
You're a poop. That's the whole thing today. Everybody should send in rabbits. For
I'm
his
not
desk.
Be here all day,
no,
so.
For Monday.
All right.
See, by the time Monday gets here, they'll arrive. Everybody should send
Perfect.
In little rabbits, any kind of rabbit, little stuffed rabbits.
Spend your money
He's
on.
A puka. That's yeah.
That's what I have.
What? What do you have? Oh, thank God, we have handbooks again. Okay, I'm happy. Did the paper arrive, or is this the last of the old paper?
Both.
This smells really good. What is this? No shit. The fact that it says Java Boulevard was kind of a giveaway. It's from Nunica, which means he brought it.
It's the leftover, all the different varieties in one bag. Coffee.
Yeah? This smells orgasmically delicious. I don't even drink coffee and that smells nice. Is this man bothering you? Okay. Did you bring coffee?
I did.
It's from Nunica. That was a giveaway.
Yeah. That's what
I just wanted to say thank
they
you.
They don't make it there. They roast it.
They don't make coffee in Nunica?
Well, they don't.
They don't grow coffee in Nunica? I totally thought they grew coffee in Nunica.
Winter beans.
They take the green
they grow,
beans and
they
make them really dark.
You're telling me they don't grow coffee in Nunica?
They do
wow.
Have a coffee tree there, though.
I'm just making morning rounds. You kids have
That's
fun.
That's good. Anyways, that is ABC coffee.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Yay!
It's not even turned on. I just had to put it back in my car, and it's really weird to carry this in my pocket.
Good morning, Batman!
What's up, sir?
Paul owes me at least 1 new meter.
What'd Paul do?
Well, you know how we fried 1 meter. Apparently fried another meter. Only half of it, though. And I know exactly what happened.
What happened?
Well, you notice this doesn't have an on-off switch, so when you turn it, it becomes on.
Yeah.
So you guys had the power on the variac, and then went through the settings, like overshot or something, because ohms and diodes and this section's fried. And
Paul,
I looked on the
Paul
board.
Killed the meter?
It can still read voltage just fine.
Okay,
so you can,
Paul?
You can keep that one for
Paul,
voltage. For voltage.
You owe me a Klein MM200.
It's like $45.
Okay. Paul? Buy a new meter, Paul. Paul broke another meter. Paul breaks a lot of things. He doesn't know about a lot of them because he'll show up, break like 50 different tools, and then run off back to Detroit. What's up, sir?
Hello.
KC's making steam engines.
Yeah, we got the cold saw back up, so I cut a few more base plates.
Okay.
One of them's a lot bigger, so I'm doing a...
How long did those cuts take?
Intuitive. Like 6 minutes.
About the same.
Unless you cut it an inch and a half thick.
Right. So I'm going to use IPS to bring it down.
Had it occurred to you to just cut a thinner slice and toss that one in, you know, material style or something? If it's way too thick, so thick that you have to make a new program for it, just...
I need 350. It's currently 500.
Okay.
It's the width of the saw blade. You want me to leave
Don't
a razor?
No. From the big bar. Cut it
this
down.
Was the big bar.
That's all that's left of the big
yes.
bar. Okay. That makes sense. Now I'm with you. I was confused for a moment. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
What's up?
Not a lot.
You making stuff?
I am.
What did you do?
Spin the coolant on?
Oh, you had to spin the valve. Okay.
Yeah. That cup gets the best in the face.
If I was doing it, I'm going to do this stuff. It's just me.
You especially not gonna
milk. You open this door right here, like that. You reach in and you spin the valve. There's nothing to it. Mm-hmm. I can do this. I got skills. You can do this one too if you want to. It's whatever you want it to be. It's just here to make you happy. So what's going on here?
I'm making like a one.
Yeah, you're making frames?
Yep.
That's pretty cool. Got any done yet, or are you just getting set up?
This is the first test run.
Yay! Okay.
So
you rock out. Look at this giant mess. We have to clean this up today. This is from Monday. Well, it's what's left after Monday. Monday was hell. But we're doing a lot better today. Ramon!
Hi.
You're taking off?
Hi.
All right. You didn't actually see him. He doesn't exist. He's a puka. We'll be back. Hey Scott, what's that operation? Reaming?
Yeah.
Okay. That's a tiny little drill bit. That's the air passages? Scott?
Yeah?
It's about to drill into the vise.
I know.
Okay. Oh, this is the first one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm with you now. This is the part that we bought those sacrificial soft jaws for. Oh, see, I didn't know that. But I remember that we just got soft jaws. I was like, oh, okay. Exciting video. And there we go. All right, tell them who you are and what
Hello.
You're doing.
I'm Edward Sarker. I have a Subaru Impreza. I pulled a P1443 code off my Subaru, and it says something about an EVAP system issue. I narrowed it down to being the canister vent solenoid at the moment, either that or I have a misfiring spark plug. We'll check on that later. This is a 13.8 volt power supply.
Car power.
And I'm running it through the solenoid to test if whether or not it actually closes the vent. And then running it, I test whether it makes a seal or not.
Okay.
So here you can click, hear it clicking on and off.
Yep. Yeah, you can see it move even.
Yep. And then you can try to blow through it now. Completely clean. Completely shut.
It's doing exactly what it's supposed to do.
My only concern is when I click it off, there's a delay. And that would matter in timing of my engine.
It depends on how fast this, how often this has to click on or off. Like, does this just go on or off like every 10 or 20 seconds, or is it going on and off like
More like 30 times a minute-ish.
30 times a minute?
Yeah.
About. That's really fast.
I would figure it'd be about that much considering the timing of the...
But even if it's 30 times a minute, alright, so that's once every 2 seconds.
Right. What I know also is the ohms range for this should be between 50 and 25.
Okay.
50 and 20.
Okay.
And 20 being the lowest end of the resistance.
Yeah.
It's at 25-ish. I actually have that thing to test it there, so
okay.
I don't know about that either. Maybe it's not getting enough juice from my power supply or wiring.
That could be it, yeah, because you're testing it with different wiring.
Right.
But I don't know. It's not uncommon for a solenoid to hang for like a fraction of a second.
Yeah.
That's pretty common.
Well, I mean, I'm getting backfires is my issue.
Okay.
So that's the only error code that pops up for the last 3 days every time I clear it.
All right.
And I don't know what else to narrow it down to. This is my first foray into it.
Poke Doogie in the IRC and see what he says.
Okay.
All right.
Cool.
Hours. Welcome to the Geek Group. It's time for viewer mail. It's a little bit early today because we got a ton of stuff going on. By the way, I want to thank everybody in the IRC who helped out in the morning show where we rocked the fundraiser hardcore. We're still holding steady at $2,500.
No, we've gotten some.
Well, it says $2,500 in there.
Well, that's out of date.
Okay, well, somebody needs to update the IRC, which means the kitten's in trouble in the IRC for not being on top of things. So we got mail from Kada. I don't know how I feel about the fact that there is a brand... Oh, it's not toilet paper, it's paper towel. Okay, because I was thinking, there's a brand of toilet paper called Sparkle. Not sure how I feel about that. But it's paper towels, so okay. I can look at that. Thank you, Kada.
That's the brand we put on our wish list.
Yeah?
It's so terrible thought in my head.
Because we need two around here.
No.
Moose, this ain't viewer mail. It's way cooler than that. It's paper for printing Geek Group member handbooks because we've printed so many Geek Group member handbooks that we had to buy more paper to do it. So that's
sorry, Jerry.
Jerry, what?
We have a shipment from Rust-Oleum. They're here with a gigantic truck.
We have a shipment from Rust-Oleum?
Yeah, a skid.
A skid?
Apparently.
Did you order something?
I didn't order anything.
They're out front with a gigantic truck.
Out front. Batman, jump on it. He's going to have to come around back. Holler at me when it's about to come off the truck. I'll try and get your mail done in time. All right, so we got a thing from Polymer Clay Express. Maybe it's some of Mr. Kidwell's espresso.
Yeah.
32 left. Ah, that's how you roll. It's molds.
Yay!
Is this something you ordered or is it on a wish list?
Wish list.
Wish list item? Gives no hints as to what it is, who ordered it, anything like that, but thank you, anonymous donor of stuff. This box weighs nothing. I'm hurrying! Rust-Oleum stuff arrived, and I don't know what. I can only imagine this is in reference to the airfoil lecture with Teddy the other day. The note, which is in all caps, is, "Sir, yes, sir! I'm feeling the energy from your teaching, sir! Have fun with your future intern, sir!" From Derek Archer. That is absolutely hilarious. There are so many things wrong with the fact that this hat was made in China and is a little bit big. That works. This is going to be a whole thing. Thank you, Derek. That's a hat I didn't have. All right. We're going to get to work now. I got to get down to Rust-Oleum, who sent us a surprise shipment of God knows what. But I'm frightfully curious. Is Teddy in today?
If he is, it's not so much later.
Okay. There will be blog.
In several states in the USA, it's still legal for an employer to discriminate against an employee based on sexual preference and orientation. Being gay, lesbian, or transgender is a fireable offense, and that's bullshit. So,
give me your twinks, your bears, your lipstick lesbians yearning to code PHP. Give me your dykes, your kinksters, your furries, and transgenders looking for more. Send these, the rainbowed sparkly code poets, to me. Compile with us. We don't care whom you adore.
Seriously, folks, are you LGBTQ or a champion for their cause? Do you have mad web developing skills? Then we want to talk to you. Visit this link and fill out an application today. Where you are in the world doesn't matter, so get in touch. Straight, bigoted asshats need not apply. In fact, we'll laugh at you if you do.
The only thing I can imagine is that it's stuff for the floor, but
they didn't send a confirmation.
They didn't send a confirmation. I didn't even order it. I just told him, like, yeah, this is what we're thinking. This is... I think. I'm not entirely sure. Because we haven't even done the grinding yet.
We haven't even finished ripping the tile off yet.
Right, Rust-Oleum is super awesome.
Yeah. Thank you, Steve. So what is it?
Solid paint.
No shit. Paint from Rust-Oleum?
Yeah, it's what I ordered.
It's yeah?
It's exactly
yeah, it's the Medici stuff.
Okay. Who would have thought, huh?
Well, we didn't actually order it. It was just an idea. We're like, is this a stuff, you know, would this work? And apparently, yes, it will work. And Steve does this every now and then. He'll just go like, he's like, yeah, it'll work. We know it's what you want. Here you go. So thank you, Rust-Oleum. Steve, you rock. We're going to have to set this somewhere safe because we're not ready for it yet, but just so they know that we're prepared.
What is this?
This is the really, really, really sexy floor covering for the everything that was covered by green tile.
Oh.
So you know what this means? We get to rip off all the rest of the green tile! Aren't you excited? Aren't you motivated? I got a hat that'll motivate you. I can do this.
Why didn't you bring it?
So, this means all the rest of the green tile gets to come off. It means you guys need to buy a hell of a lot of green tiles because we got to rent a concrete grinder to get the floor prepped. We got to do all the preparation work because that's the secret to applying quality Rust-Oleum paint. Proper preparation prevents piss poor performance. It's all the prep.
So, I think the next person to get a set of bolt deep up thread gauges says
yeah.
How many pounds this skid is.
How many pounds does this skid weigh?
Because it's not what you think.
No?
No.
It's heavier than you think? I'm guessing by a lot, so. All right, we'll be back.
Hi.
You come out and say hi? Hey, dude. No. Okay, fine. So what are you guys working on?
I'm working on this purse that I made from recycled scraps of velvet.
Okay.
And a pair of blue jeans.
Okay.
And he's replacing his wonderful ancient hunting pants with a new zipper, which I have here. I just cut it out of another pair of pants.
Cool.
So.
Okay.
And he just learned to sew.
He'll get it.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's good. Wait until he figures out the embroidery stuff.
I haven't figured that out yet either.
You should get on that. It's really cool.
I know.
It's big fun. That's some creepy shit you've got there. I've seen the pictures on your Facebook, and just show the world you're creepy. This is...
Creepy good, not
yeah.
creepy bad.
No, things like that are why I don't do drugs anymore.
We're having our first Wednesday workshop tonight from 6 to 8 p.m.
Yeah?
Mixed media collage.
Mixed media collage, 6 to 8 p.m. tonight.
All materials included, instruction, and
yeah?
lots of fun.
What's it cost to come?
It's $20 for the first person, and if you bring a friend, it's only $10.
Cool.
And we're doing different activities every Wednesday in arts and crafts from 6 to 8.
Pimp this hard on the Facebook.
We are.
Okay.
Did you see this?
Did I see what? This? This is the latest version?
This is the good version.
This is the good version of the new, the little trifold.
The trifold brochure.
Hey, come check us out, trifold. Yes. Okay. It's really nice.
I do all right at that design.
Yeah. I like it. Print 100 of them.
All right.
How many pieces of paper like that do you have?
500.
Print 500 of them. We'll get them out to people. Because that's the kind of thing we could put out at several local places. Just like, you know, put a stack of them on a counter at all the gas stations. 50 Shades of Brian Gray!
Thank you for
being
my name.
Yeah. I know my name.
Huh?
I know my name.
Yeah. So, should we tell the world?
Okay.
Okay. Hey, Moose! Come here! He needs a new card.
Okay.
G4 his ass.
Okay.
So you go like, what?
He's the director of robotics for the Geek Group.
Yay!
I like the term curator.
Okay.
Because it's a...
I like the word moxie, too.
Yeah,
but
true.
You're the director of robotics for the Geek Group.
Can it could be like
a robot on this card.
You can put a little robot on this card. So you want to come look at the department?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I had a little bit of after you said 4 o'clock, I thought, yeah, it's all right.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I can't believe you were dumb enough to want to like head that department and clean up the mess.
It's a clean slate of awesome.
It is a clean slate of awesome, but the slate, it's, oh God. Oh, nobody's ever done it before. I've tried to get a couple guys to do it, and I can't get anybody who wants to do it. So you jumped. I was like, yeah, I was like, wow, okay. Cool.
Everybody's
so
in every other corner here.
Here's the robotics lab when Brian took over. This has been a catch-all for all of it. There's stuff down here that belongs in at least three other departments. Because the recording studio is under construction, so all the recording studio stuff's down here. You've got, it's packed with shit from hell to breakfast. You've got 50 pounds of shit in a 10-pound bag. So, I'm going to help you. Because I can't let you do it on your own. You'll destroy a lot of stuff and kill yourself.
No, I don't
want to
do that.
But I'm going to help you out.
Oh my God, there's shelves. I didn't even remember.
There are shelves.
I thought there was shelves.
There are shelves.
That's better than
now, I don't know how many of those shelves are going to stay down here.
Yeah.
And if any that do stay are probably going to move. But there are shelves.
That's a shelf right there.
That's a shelf. This shelf should have shelves. And if we could get Rexroth, the Rexroth division of Bosch, to help us out, we could actually do this room up really awesome. But I can't get them to do anything because Bosch Rexroth's local distributor kind of sucks. I'd also be cool with doing the 80/20 stuff, so we should reach out to them. They both make the same stuff. One of them makes it a lot better than the other, but they both make the same stuff.
I've got a redneck where 2x4 would do it.
No.
So.
No. Absolutely not.
No.
But we can clean this out a lot, and a lot of this stuff can go other places, and we can make it better. So
yes.
I will give you a couple points to start on, and we can go from there.
Yeah.
But you're in charge of robotics, which means you're going to get to make a lot of robots work. There's no less than 5 robots that we have that are just waiting on someone like you to say, okay, I'm going to make that work.
And if I can't do that, I can provide an environment conducive to other people.
Yes.
Hopefully doing that, which is what I like to
do. Oh, we have to paint this room.
Oh, wait, okay.
This whole room needs painting.
Oh, great. Now you spring it up.
The floor's done. So you've got that going for you. We did the floor. That was a month of hell.
Okay.
The walls down here, that's easy. We can do that. But we got to paint the walls.
Alright.
Needs to be pretty. So, we'll make it happen.
Cool.
We'll be back. 1644 hours! I have my motivational speaking hat. And we are moving stuff in an orderly, proficient military manner. Brian's very excited.
I am.
We're making clean spots. We've already filled the van. We're hauling all kinds of shit out of here. Antique shit that we don't need, that will not further the mission of this organization, will be eliminated. Things like 20-year-old printers that we don't know where the hell we have, and we didn't even know we had it. We had a pile of printers down here buried under a shelf. Nobody knew they were there. If I'd known they were there, we'd have thrown them away months ago. Jay!
Hi.
How you doing, sir?
Good.
Cool.
Good.
Grab a panel, or 2, or 12.
Because you didn't yell enough before.
I got a motivational speaking hat.
Yeah.
Are you feeling motivated?
Take one.
Okay. Go and sin no more.
All right. After we get all that, I want to get the cardboard in the truck, too.
Check this out. Frames! Look at them. They're beautiful. We have frames happening. All the bases, frames, cylinders. It's happening. I'm excited.
It's happening!
I'm excited! We're gonna be selling them soon.
Yeah.
This is really badass.
Can't take you seriously with that cardboard hat on.
It's a great hat. I like this hat. You know what a real one costs?
$16 last time I looked.
Really?
Yeah. No, they're more than
I don't know.
You can go to the costume shop.
I don't want a shitty costume shop.
No. This is a shitty costume shop.
Yeah, I know. This is a shitty costume
shop. You can get one that quality, the proper felt, at a proper costume shop. Not like the cheap Halloween store. Proper, like,
I want a legit Marine Corps one.
It's the same quality. It just wasn't worn by some sweat yet.
I'd rather have one worn by the inspired with the rar of a legit drill instructor. It's the only way it could be better. But this hat is pretty awesome. This is my starter hat. I gotta learn how to yell properly.
Why you gotta be the dick, Rocco?
Can't find the other one.
Don't say, okay.
Calm your tits.
I get nervous. Hey. Saves the drive out of this.
Yeah, I saw that.
Okay.
I was going to save it whether you wanted it to or not.
Okay.
I got a thing for old things like that.
Give me a screwdriver. Give me a screwdriver. It goes like that.
Soon something slides, maybe?
Well, you gotta pop the other side out, too.
I had multiple screwdrivers. Alright, I got this.
Okay, now will it slide out? Does that do it? Okay, then you gotta take out these screws and these screws back here.
Some jack just hadn't walked away with my impact. Circles that says remove on back for chest.
Oh, it looks like we're not the first person to have that problem.
How the fuck?
It comes right out now. How about that?
Let's go move a cap. Jerry!
What are we moving?
Come on.
We gotta take the cap off. You know, we gotta quit.
The weather got nice at least.
You know it'd be fun? Totally using a fire truck to do a strap run.
It doesn't have any room to haul anything.
No, but we could, like, put the trailer on it. It'd be hilarious.
Jerry, backside.
Well, I always gotta get the backside. You're good at it.
You run. Put it right in. You do it like this? Yeah, it's unhooked.
I'm just that tired. Oh,
Which way are we going? We gotta go back, I guess.
Sit it on the flatbed. Take it to the dump. Back her up to it. Lift it up.
Now we won't, because it can all go in the trailer flat.
Well, for that, but I also got to put the cardboard in there.
Which we probably want to.
See, we put all right on a trailer. It's easy. It's awesome. Yay!
Then come back.
Probably come in the truck.
GH plug
as well?
Huh? Yeah. That's the paint for the lobby. Okay. Oh, I didn't know if you were here for that. Time is 1948 hours. Brian kicked Major ass down here today. There's a path, Batman. Look at that.
There's actually progress. You can't tell unless you actually get down here all the time.
But it's wow, he worked his ass off. There's a real path.
Said he was going to go get food. I don't know if that was clarifying. He was coming back.
I think he bailed and we'll never see him again. But, look at this. We got a whole bunch of vacuum tubes. This is cool. These are going to go in the vacuum tube collection. And yes, the Geek Group is maintaining a stockpile of vacuum tubes. And now we have some nifty tube holders as well. So that's going to be a whole thing. But all of this, a lot of this is AV gear that needs to go like in the studio, which we need to build the studio. It's making me more than a little crazy.
Like a path over here.
Is there a path down the middle too?
You can actually kind of get to the
path. Holy shit, there is a path. All the way to the shelving.
I need to get them some more wood for these.
Yeah. But I'll bet we can make that happen. And we got to find a really good spot for these. There's a lot to do about it.
Yeah.
But we'll get there. This is how it begins. This is the beginning of robotics. We gotta make paths, which will allow us to clean out a lot of shit. Then we clean out a lot of shit, which will reduce the volume of shit in the room. Then we move everything away from the walls. We paint the walls.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. So, this is how it starts, so I'm excited. You know what I miss?
Mm.
You know what I really, really miss?
Mm.
Down here, locked away in the deep, dark recesses of the building, is about a third of my drum set. That is somebody set up really weird, because that's not how I set it up, but there is bits of my drum set hidden away. Here, set that. I'll trade you for my cell phone.
Yeah, here you go.
How about that? Thank you.
But
like my drum set is just sitting down here, quietly waiting. I don't know who's a short person set it up.
Might have been Joe.
A short person who likes to really crowd the snare drum set it up.
Well, you have so much room.
Someone
Who does this?
My snare just disengaged.
Some might need to be tightened.
No, the snare's always been a piece of shit. But it wasn't that bad of a piece of shit. This needs, like, a pillow. Really bad. And the carpet, because it's marching away.
It's really weird, my bed's still standing. And not a towel.
At least they didn't lose your telephone bells. Your telephone
that's,
bells.
That's pretty cool. We gotta...
I remember making that little...
I gotta get an ice bell. I used to have one a million years ago. And it got stolen at a gig. I had a pair of them. It's called an ice bell. I can't remember who makes it. But it's a common, like LP percussion or somebody like that makes it. I had a pair of these things. It's called an ice bell. And it was like this part of a cymbal, that's the bell of a cymbal, mm-hmm. was really crazy thick and really small. Like I had two of them, like a 6-inch and an 8-inch or something like that. And they used to sit right here. And you could just, it was cool. It was like having a good, it was like a good cymbal, ride cymbal bell. It was bam, bam, and it had a really good cutting sound to it. And we were loading out, we played a gig at, what was it called? It was the coffee shop that went out of business in Kozu that used to be right by where Water Street is. And we were playing a gig there, and we were doing, like, I had them through the whole show. We played two sets. And then when I got back and was unloading the truck, they weren't there. So they got stolen at some point in the middle. I was really pissed about that. But those were good. And I want to make, you and I could have fun with this. I want to take a big piece of steel tubing and mm-hmm. make a tubular bell. Like one,
yeah.
Just one bell, just whang! And I just think it'd be really cool to have like something like 8 feet high, just on a big boom stand. So. Who would set? Why would you? It's with the angle over, because this is like in this plane, and then this one's like here, and it totally. You gotta have flow. You got no flow. I don't know who set up my drums, but don't. Because you got no flow, and you got it because you need to be able to. And you're cockeyed. This is a cockamamie drum setup, is what it is.
That was so well done.
See, if you hook that in there, it might keep it from moving away. here.
Oh, yeah. I keep my ride, like, hovering right here. My ride's usually back and hovering low. And just right, just barely, like, you can... And this goes much more over here. Because this shit, I don't know. We can bring this.
You guys, this could just very well be how it was just set up when it was last moved.
Huh?
When it was last moved, shit just probably got adjusted and they just set it down to kind of look like...
I'm guessing.
Let me get back in there.
We gotta set this up in a real studio. We gotta build a drum room. That's always been a shitty symbol. Just park your foot right
there. That's what I'm doing.
Yeah?
Okay. Yeah, there you go.
This should be about here. These should be way closer together than over here. It should be doom 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 bam bam boom doom bam doom boom. And you need that. And you can't. That's you're going like 45 degrees of arc on that. God, how long has it been since I sat down for a drum set?
Huh.
It's gotta be. The last time we had these set up was up in D.
Yeah.
And that was before D had...
I don't know how often you play, though, with your... I know electric is completely different, but...
Yeah, I don't get to play my electric barely at all. If I'm upstairs, I'm editing or officing.
That's all right. We'll just start hanging out. We'll get Jabroni on the trombone. I'll start practicing sax. We'll start having jazz.
We got a fucking ska band right there.
Yeah.
Drums and a trombone. We're a ska band. They took the red one and hit it.
Because
the red one makes that sound that you don't hear it. You feel it in your teeth.
Yeah,
and just
Oh, no, the red one's sitting
right... I don't even know where
the red one's sitting right behind you.
Where?
Right on
the... Oh, it's way back there on my real snare.
On your real snare.
See, that's the real... This is the shitty, like...
Those strings have seen better days.
Yeah, that's a shitty snare. So you go over here, and I got this nice piccolo snare. And it's got... It's tuned as tight as a funeral drum with that hydraulic, like... I don't know, like a five-layer head on it. And it just... That's how a snare should sound. Beautiful. See, that's... It's really loose.
Hold on. There, now.
I think it's just that every drummer has one. I probably...
You gotta use it at least once, man.
I don't think I've ever used this in a show or anything. Like, I hate it. I have never used it. Really, really loose. Like, look at that.
Yeah, that's...
There's... It's also kind of
this
weird
this room has like no temperature control.
drums.
Alright, I'm gonna go edit blog. Brian did real accomplishment down here, and a lot of other people helped. Jerry helped, and Batman helped. I helped a little bit, and Elizabeth helped, and Stephen helped, and I'm sure there was some Casey got involved a little bit. So, yeah, it's getting there. We're making a dent. This will be a robotics lab that you will be able to come and use soon. And the guy in charge of it all is the 50 Shades of Brian Gray.
That's quite the beard.
It is quite the beard. It's the beard that Lewis wishes he could grow.
What?
Where are you going?
He just wants to love you.
What's that sound?
A long skinny drill.
Oh, okay. You're making ones?
Making ones. You're
still making ones?
Yeah.
Sounds like you're making another one.
Yes. That was funny the first time I said it.
That's it keeps getting funnier every time I say it. So what are you doing?
Waiting around.
For?
Nikki to get out of work.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna go.
I gotta go past Meyer to get to my house. And so they go past Meyer, then come back to Meyer, then go back home. So I just chill here.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go do a show and I'll entertain you.
Alright.
We gotta get a fire truck.
Yeah. 26.
What the shit is this?
Oh! Finally, I forgot about that. So I went to Padnos and they just had the top layer of their nickel brass combo had a bunch of trophy parts in it. Like,
oh, they're trophy parts. But so you want to put these on here like the Mercy
Seat?
Like
the Ark of the Covenant tops a little bit. They're a little off. I just thought it'd be hilarious to melt them because they probably will melt.
So this is what you do. You scan that. Okay. Mm-hmm. You 3D laser scan
it. Oh, yeah. And then we can make it.
You have Moose help you 3D laser scan it. Now you've got art. And then you modify that with the wings. They got to be like this.
They go forward. That's right.
Yeah, they go forward. Okay. And then you can scale it up really easily. And then you 3D print it in pieces, because we can't put anything in. So you 3D print it in pieces, and then you glue all the pieces together, and we cast a mold. And now you've got to cast it. And that's how it starts.
Yeah.
Or you just go...
The other option was
of aluminum
this,
and we machine it out.
This lady had a lot of dog trophies, too. I just... Two dogs.
Did you get dogs?
No, I didn't. I just grabbed...
Do you need to go back and go look into the pile?
Because
they need to be big.
There were three things. The dogs were bigger. The dogs were the top of the trophy. These are usually on the side.
Okay.
And then the top. The other option, it was dogs. There was a microphone.
I want a microphone trophy.
And it was just the top, like... It wasn't the whole trophy, it's just...
That's
the,
okay, we'll make a trophy.
And then it was a marching band girl in this position. And then
she got a little captain in her.
Yeah, a little captain in her. And the dogs. Yeah, there are several different dogs.
You gotta go get these.
I might have to.
If he doesn't give them to you outright, he'll sell them to you for like $1 a pound or some stupid thing. You gotta go get the trophy tops. It's way too much fun to be headed without.
This was an entire Gaylord, just covered in like the top layer was just trophy parts.
Yeah, you gotta get it. Yeah, it's too much fun to be had there. I'm gonna go do a show. Hi. Were you playing the drums or something?
No, I heard someone pounding.
I thought it was you.
Why would I play drums?
You're the musical guy.
Under what total circumstances would I sync that up?
You're the musical guy and everybody else I saw. I've been shooting blog. Wait, fuck you, Sync Low, you goddamn horn line! Good night, guys.